Good morning to you. It's great to see you here. Good morning to you. You're someone we can cheer. Hooray. Good morning to you. Singing clear and loud.
And welcome to week one of Space to Create with me, Janey, and my colleague artist, Yair, who you will see later on in the video. Each week, I'll be bringing you lots of fun activities along with some other artists that I work with in four different sections that are called Magic Make, Drawing Date, Awesome Artist, and Mind and Body. We hope that you're really going to enjoy working on a wide range of activities with lots of different people. This week, I'm excited to start with the Magic Make, where I'll be helping you to make something called an Arperilla. These originated in Chile in South America, where they're traditionally made by women to tell stories of their everyday life. These can be sad stories or happy stories. So you'll be able to choose whenever you're making yours. We'll be making them just by using scraps of fabric and paper that you've got around the house. So hopefully you'll have everything that you need already indoors. Okay, so looking forward to seeing you in a minute for some magic making. So we're going to start with our Arperilla making. I quite like to stand up whenever I work. It just means I can kind of move about a bit more easily. So what you need, what the bits you can gather from around your house are a piece of coloured paper or card. It can be plain white as well. That's absolutely fine. About A4 size. It can be any size, but A4 is probably the one that's easiest to get hold of. That's going to be your background. And then in order to decorate your background, you just need any bits and pieces of collage material or scraps of paper, bits of old magazines, maybe some bits of paintings that you don't want anymore that you can cut up. Some of this is actually, this is kitchen roll with just lots of paint splattered and blotted on it. So it makes it like a really nice effect. So just anything that you've got that's decorative and colourful in the colours that you like. Okay, so just a pile of pieces like that. We're going to need some glue. Just ordinary PVA glue is absolutely fine. A pair of scissors, some coloured card. I've just got one colour of card because I'm only going to use one, but you could use more than one colour if you wanted. And something that you can draw or decorate with. I've got these lovely oil pastels, but you could also use felt pens or crayons, colouring pencils, anything that you've got lying around the house is absolutely fine. So we're going to start by opening up our oil pastels and decorating our kind of skyline. So what we've got up in the sky. So I'm going to start by drawing a nice warm sun. What's nice is that you can do either a day scene or a night scene, or you know what, you could mix it up, make it a bit imaginary and go for both. You could do a mashup of day and night. So I'm going to do that by putting some stars in the sky, even though I've got the sun kind of shining. And because it's a kind of inventive and imaginary, you can kind of use colours in a quite an inventive and imaginary sort of way. You don't have to use like spot on realistic colours. Like you can see my background is yellow and I've got some blue rays coming out of my sun. Okay, so I've done my kind of skyline. And then what I'm going to do is layers of background mountains and then foreground hills, so that I create the idea of depth in my arpiera. And that's traditionally how the women in Chile made them, because there are mountains in Chile and a lot of them feature the mountains. So I'm going to go along with that tradition and I'm going to draw some mountains, a mountain range. It will sit. So what I'm going to do this time, my first arpiera, I made them kind of snow-capped mountains, but this time I'm going to make them kind of like lava-capped mountains. So you can decorate your mountains in any way you like. And then we're just going to cut out the mountain tops. Okay, so I can also cut along here because I don't need, I only need the tops of my mountains. They're going to sit along there. I'm going to have my mountains kind of overlapping my sun a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to stick my mountains to my background. So I'm just using dots of glue. Just a dot, not a lot, because I don't want it to be swimming in glue at the end. And what I'm not doing is sticking down the very, very tips of the mountains. And I'm going to explain why in a second. So just give it a nice little press down. But you can see that because I haven't stuck down the tips, they're kind of sitting forward a little bit. It gives it a slightly 3D sort of look. Okay. Don't worry about any excess glue. You can wipe it on there because you're going to stick more stuff on top. So next, I want to do a layer of hills in front of the mountains. So I'm just going to use this. This is more kind of kitchen rolly kind of stuff that I've just used to blot up whenever I've been tidying up my paints and things. And I'm just going to do a layer of hills in front. So again, I'm going to just glue that roughly into place. Just dots of glue. But I'm not going to worry about sticking every bit of it down, because again, you can see the tops are still kind of sticking up. They're sticking out, and I like that 3D look. Okay. And a few more layers. I think I might use this paper this time. So at this stage, doesn't matter at all if you've got bits sticking off the side like that. I'm going to show you how to trim that in a minute. Okay, so again, I'm just going to stick this down. Just dots of glue. So we're just building up our piece of work. So you can have as many layers as you like, because each layer kind of makes the landscape look like it's coming more and more towards you. You're building up layers and layers. And you could always have a layer that would be a river, like a blue kind of riverish layer. I'm going to do a layer of brown paper. And I think to finish off, we'll do one more really colourful there. And I like just ripping rather than cutting, because I like the jaggedy edges that you get whenever you rip something. But you might like it to be really neat, so you might want to cut it. So again, I'm just going to glue that down, pop the glue on here, stick that down. Okay. Oh, that looks good. So we now have our background in shape, and once it's stuck well enough, you can just turn it over and trim away with the scissors all the extra bits. So I'm just basically going around the edge of the yellow paper and I'm cutting away all the extra bits. And while I'm here at the back, I just give it a nice back rub. That just helps all the glue to stick into place. And here we are. We have a very nice finished background. Now, if I show you my one from earlier, you can decorate your background. I've put houses on here. So houses that are up close are bigger than houses that are in the distance. So again, you can give the illusion of depth in your piece by making the houses slightly different sizes, going smaller each time. And I've given them little roofs, but you can also just draw directly on. So you might just want to make this a nature scene, and you might want to draw. So I'm just drawing some grasses. And in Arpieras, they very often had people. So you can draw a little person if you want, and it can just be like a stick figure. It doesn't need to be anything really impressive. So you might draw a few people. It could be you and your family. And just remember that you're trying to tell a story with your piece. So you could have a really happy feeling piece, or you could have a bit of sadness if you're not feeling too good. If you're really missing your friends at the minute, you could put you and your friends in your piece. Anything that you like. So there we are. So for the final stage, you will see that because these originated from textile pieces, I like to have a little bit of sewing in place, and I'm going to show you in the next step how to do that. So see you in a second. So here we are with our almost finished Arpiera. Remembering that Arpieras like to tell stories, I decided to draw myself in between these two little people, because these are my children. And I wanted to remember us going out in nature. This is a beautiful flowery field in the background. That's what the lovely paper reminded me of. So I just remembered happy times of being outdoors, which at the minute we're not getting outdoors quite as much. So it's just nice to think about that. So I'm going to show you the final stage of just pulling your Arpiera piece together like I've done here. This is decorative, but it also holds all the layers together, so it's functional as well as being very pretty. So this is a little bit of sewing, and you can do it in a couple of different ways depending on what materials you've got around the house. So if you've got something like this, which is a hole puncher, so your mum and dad might have one. Sometimes they've got two bits on them for punching holes in paper. And if you've got one of them, you can go around the edge punching holes. Oops. So I'm just going to do some holes along one side. It's good to get a grown-up's help with it because it can be a little stiff. So if you want, you can make holes the whole way around the edge if you've got a hole puncher. And then you can take a piece of wool or yarn. If it's nice and thick, it's good because it stands out. Otherwise, you could twist a couple of different coloured bits together. And I've put a piece of tape just on the end, just to make it easier to get in and out of the holes. And you can put a little knot in it to stop it from coming through. And then you just start by threading it through. And you can either do a stitch by going round the back so that it kind of overlaps like this. Or if you preferred, you could do a running stitch which goes in at the front like that and then in through the back like that. You could try various stitching techniques, and you could even mix it up and do alternative ones. So you're pulling your yarn in and out through the holes. Okay, so that you've got a variety of techniques. So you can do it the whole way around the edge. Or if you don't have a hole punch and wool or yarn, but you've got needle and thread, preferably thicker embroidery style thread, but whatever thread you've got is absolutely fine. You can actually just sew right into your paper. And you can just sew big stitches. So just don't go too close to the edge because the paper can rip a little bit. Yeah, you can do nice big stitches all along the edge. And remember, in art there are no rules, so if you find a better way of doing this, or a more imaginative, inventive way of doing it, you can do it that way. So you can sew down the side. Oops. And start sewing these bits into place. So, there we are. We have a couple of different ways of finishing off your arpillera. So that's a couple of different ones to give you a bit of inspiration. And I really hope that you can enjoy making your own story. And don't forget, you can put it in the window of your home so that other people passing by can see your beautiful arpillera artwork. Imagine how cheered up they would feel to see something so lovely and colourful. So thank you for watching Magic Make. So welcome to Drawing Date. This week we are going to do something which is really simple but really effective. We're going to make blobs of paint or ink or anything that you've got available to hand, and we're going to turn them into little birds or other little characters. I've used birds because I, on my daily walks, I've been hearing the birds a bit more than normal, and really appreciating them because I'm not able to get out as much at the minute. So I'm really noticing all the wildlife around me, and as I say, in particular, the birds. So it's very easy. All that you need is a piece of paper and a fine tip pen. I've just got a biro, and either paints or inks or anything that you can make quite liquidy. So what I'm doing is I'm just adding lots of water to my paint. This is just ordinary poster paint, and then I'm just making some blobs in whatever shape, maybe vaguely bird shape. If I think about a bird's wings or something like that, I might think, oh, they might go a bit like that. But I'm really just having lots of fun, just making any old shape. And I will see how I will turn that into a bird later. So I'm not worrying too much about what I'm doing. I'm just making shapes, making blob sort of shapes. And I might even just let some kind of run, lift my page and let them run and see what happens. And I've got an old toothbrush here, and I'm just going to do a few speckledy bits by flicking my toothbrush. So I'm just dipping it into my paint, making a kind of speckled background. Now, you can wait for it to dry completely, or you can speed up the process using a bit of kitchen roll. So I'm just going to do that by laying my kitchen roll across. So there we are, I've just dried off the paint a little bit. And now my page is ready to get the details of the birds. So I might see a bird's head there. That looks very like a bird now. That really looks like a wing. And you can add in a bit of detail into the wing if you want. And these look like they would be little legs coming down here. So that's very bird-like. This went a bit out of shape, but I think it actually looks a bit like a big peacock. This all looks like one big kind of peacock to me. And remember, it doesn't need to look anything like what the real bird would. These are kind of bird-like monster characters, if you like. I could add in some details like the feathers you get on a peacock. This bird definitely looks like it's flying. And maybe this over here is something different. Maybe it's a bit of a tree. So you can change your mind halfway through and make things into something else. So I think this is a kind of tree. So there we are. I've allowed my blobs and splotches to become quite interesting nature shapes. So see what you can do by just having a play around and turning it into something a bit unusual.
Hello and welcome back to our next section in this video. In this section, every week, one of us will introduce you to a musician or an artist that we believe that you should know about, because they have something important to tell us, perhaps about ourselves, perhaps about the world we're living in. And this week, in this week's section, I'm going to talk about Bob Marley. Bob Marley was the most successful reggae musician and the person who basically brought reggae music from Jamaica to the masses and to huge success all around the world, especially here in the UK in the 1970s. He actually came here and recorded music here with his band from Kingston, Jamaica, back in the day. Bob Marley was important not just because of his cool music, but also because of his message. And his message was one of hope and love and standing up for bullying, basically. Standing up against dictatorships and leaders who treated their people badly. And Bob Marley gave people hope by telling them that they should not tolerate bad behavior from their leaders. And he continued to do that very strongly throughout his career with amazing music, but also amazing performances. He was very powerful in his performances, not just his vocal performance, but also the way he moved on stage. He had a lot of charisma and he conveyed this message of hope to the masses, and that is why he was so popular. But above all, really, it's the fun and amazing groovy music that he created with his band, The Wailers. And that he had a 20 years career before he passed away at a very young age, a long time ago now. He's still considered a huge legend, and we will listen to some of his music right now through my record player, and we will give you a link that you can check on with YouTube to a video of Bob Marley. Here it is. Dance along if you like in your bedrooms. This next exercise is for you, and it's a chance for you to completely relax. Stop whatever it is that you're doing and give yourself a lovely moment of peace. It will only take a few minutes, and I would like to invite you now to sit comfortably wherever you are, or you can even lie down. You can pause this video for a second if you need a moment to arrange a comfy and nice spot for yourselves where you can feel totally calm. Okay, now that you're all ready, I would like to invite you to close your eyes. I'm going to play the singing bowls one more time to get us into the mood, and then I'll invite you to open your ears and listen as you close your eyes. As the sound of the singing bowls fades away, I would like to invite you to now listen deeply and carefully to all the sounds that you can hear around you. Notice the sounds inside your room, inside your house, and also the sounds from outside. And then pay attention and notice your own breathing. It might help if you place your hand on your belly like that. And notice how every time you breathe in, your belly goes out like you're blowing a balloon. And then as you breathe out, you're letting all the air out. And for the next exercise, I will count and guide you to breathe slowly, deep through inside through your nose, then you'll pause your breath, and then you'll let it go through your mouth again. So we're breathing through the nose, we pause, and then we release. Ready to breathe in? Take a deep breath through your nose. Pause, 2, 3, and blow out. Very, very good. One more time, deep breath with your nose, pause and blow out. And last time, breathing in through your nose, 2, 3, and out. Great. So now I would like you to just try and remember how you're feeling, this moment of peace and calm. You're feeling safe, you're feeling peaceful within, you're not worried because you know that you're safe and you're doing fine. All that there is right now is this feeling of peace inside of you. Let's say these words to ourselves now, together with me. We're going to say, I am safe, I feel calm, I'm okay. Let's say it together. I am safe, I feel calm, I'm okay. Thank you.
It's time to say goodbye now. It's time for us to finish. Thank you for your music, and we'll see you next week. It's time to say goodbye now.
I will be here every week with Yair, and we'll be joined by different guest artists. If you've had a good time and enjoyed making something, do share photos or even a video with Catherine at Culture Shift. Check out this email address at the end of the video. Okay.
some more.